of stuck here. The cops won't bother me.
So when you're riding a GS, I think, you know, even though I bash BMW quite often, my bashing comes from a different point of view that a lot of motor journalists and people with a lot of money don't have. And that is just the bang for the dollar and durability, reliability, and just the ability of having a bike that just seems to work in every condition. Now, if you remove those, the BMW makes a lot of sense. Sure, it's got a very high price point. Sure, it has a very high service fee. But the bike itself works well. Having the boxer engine, it's a strange engine, but it's a nice engine because it's like very down low to the ground. And it's very easy to service. You know, you might not even have to pull the gas tank off for a lot of the things. And that makes it a very interesting bike to own. And I've always heard that like riders do put lots of miles on the GSs, and that's true, they do. But the part that you don't hear about is the problems they usually have. So for example, I can take any Yamaha Super 10 ride, just go buy it on Craigslist, and even if it was abused, quote unquote abused, it's still going to work probably better than a GS that was routinely serviced. That's one of the things that a lot of people don't pay attention. It's that Japanese bikes, they have such a high degree of finish, and the finish, it has more to do with bikes just being built so well that they don't really require a lot of work. And that's what the Tenray is all about. Now, when it comes to handling and all of these things, yeah, you're actually going to be better off with a GS for riding. It even has a lower weight. With lower weight, that means that it's easier to ride. When it comes to buying a GS as opposed to the Tenray, I think you're going to see two rationales. For example, the BMW GS guys, they absolutely love the Beamer. And I've ridden quite a few of them, and they're fun to ride because it's a very unique engine. That boxer engine, it feels fantastic when you're riding it. And it does have a certain je ne sais quoi. And they handle well. I think if you've ever ridden with any of the guys from the ADV groups, you'll realize that those guys can ride fairly well. Or actually really well. I should give them a good compliment. And the Tenray, I think the people that get this bike as opposed to the GS are different. I think they're more like me. They want a bike that just works and it doesn't cost a ton to maintain. And that's a problem. Like, you cannot really neglect the maintenance on the BMW. On the GS though, it's a much more different beast. And when you sell a BMW, I think people that know BMW, they know that if you haven't done the maintenance, then it could cost you thousands down the line. And literally, it'll cost you thousands down the line. So the reason for getting this Tenray is that it's a bike that you don't have to spend thousands to keep it running. It just simply works. You know, you just get on it and it runs. You can pass the service intervals, like the valve adjustments, and it's not going to need any major work. I can't really say the same thing for the BMW. Now, if you're a guy that makes a lot of money, and I think this is the BMW thing, is that if you're a guy that you have a lot of money, then yeah, go ahead and get the GS. I think it's going to give you a very good experience. And when it comes time to service it, you'll just pay it. You know, you'll might grunt a little bit when you get $1,000 to fix a problem, but that's no big deal. With the Tenray, you don't have to worry about that. So the people that get this are people that are a little bit more rational with their spending, as opposed to a guy with a BMW that's got, you know, way too much money. And usually what they say, GS guys say, that the reason they bought the GS is that this would take $5,000 more to get it up to the level of the GS. And I'm not really quite sure what they mean other than like the creature comforts. And I think if you have such a demanding lifestyle, then yeah, get the BMW. Probably has the better creature comforts that you require, but I think that's not the reason for getting a motorcycle. I think for me, getting a motorcycle like this is, I can climb on this, ride it to California. It's not going to have any issues. Another thing that BMW guys say is that they have a service locations everywhere. But the part that they don't tell you is that their Yamaha, their service locations and shops everywhere for Yamahas. And not only that, but every single Japanese manufacturer shop will fix a Yamaha, because all of these are almost universal. You know, the Yamaha Tenere is kind of like the PC of Japanese bikes, or Japanese bikes are the PCs of motorcycles. And when you get a BMW, KTM, they're like the Apples. I think people want that kind of passion that those manufacturers give you. But I think I like this one a lot more because the Tenere is the underdog of ADV bikes. And especially these are the 2012s, and I wouldn't recommend the early ones because they usually have more issues. This one's got 52,000 miles on it now, but you wouldn't know it. That's the interesting thing about this, is that it is so good that it still feels like it's a brand new bike. And I took a chance with this, driving 6 hours and then riding it back, and sight unseen, and that is a testament of Japanese quality. I don't think I would do that with the BMW, and I wouldn't do that with a BMW that I didn't know the owner, because oftentimes there's two types of BMW owners: the guys that get them new and the guys that get them used. The guys that get them used are trying to get into that BMW market, but that price tag just eludes them a little bit, so they get it used and they don't know what they're getting. And oftentimes, if a BMW starts to have issues, it's going to be very expensive to fix. With this, I never really have to worry about it breaking. I never have to worry about it having issues. It's a fine bike for what it is. I think one of the issues is that it's a large bike, but when you compare it to the GS, I believe the GS is slightly lighter than this. But I think it does feel it, because the engine on the GS, the pistons are down here, so it of course is going to feel much lighter. And that is the beauty of the GS, is that when you're riding it, it does feel like it's a lighter bike, because the weight is just so much further down low. But also, it's got this massive width to it. I mean, this one's wide, but the GS is just so much further, like, wide. And you know, honestly, the GS is like the old white man's motorcycle. You know, the BMWs, I think people have fallen out of favor with the BMW, and especially the GS, with the increasing competition from ADV bikes. I think people are starting to see that perhaps the GS is not that great of a bike anymore. I can't see why anybody would choose that over an Africa Twin or even a KTM. And people are starting to get into the smaller bikes anyway. But I just wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about the GSs. Also, the GS guys, they're a different type of guys. They're very much brand loyal. And that's something that I can't stand, is the brand loyalty. You know, this Yamaha is almost interchangeable. It just works. You know, it's a bike that you don't need too much to live with it. I mean, sure, it doesn't sound as cool as a GS, but it's got everything I want out of an adventure bike. You'll never convince a BMW cult leader that a Yamaha Tenere is better, but it might not be better when it comes to overall machinery if you have plenty of money. But it's better in a way that people don't expect. It's like, this bike is going to cost you less money to run than the BMW. But I know that a lot of guys don't care. I'm not one of those guys. I do care. For me, motorcycling has always been about cheap transportation and a little bit on the therapy side of things. So whenever I talk to BMW guys, they're willing to completely forget the durability issues and the reliability issues and the engineering problems that it has in exchange for something that they see as being a little bit more passionate. And I think that's probably what BMW does, is they give you that image of traveling. You know, oftentimes you'll get BMW guys and they're like, oh, haven't you seen Long Way Around? Charlie and that Ewan guy, they rode those bikes. Yeah, but that's not that impressive. I mean, really, I'm much more impressed by Itchy Boots riding on a Royal Enfield than I am Ewan and Charlie on BMW, sponsored by BMW, and then having support trucks follow them with motorcycle parts.
So where are you headed?
Aspen.
California. Beautiful.